But ladies and gentlemen, you've all received a gospel tract. Please read those. It's the love of God that compels me to come out here and share this message with you. If we were to divide this group of people, this wonderful group of people, we can divide us into two different people groups. The first group are those that are not saved, that are not born again. And then the second part of this people group are those that are born again, those that are saved from their sins. I'm going to read two passages out of the scriptures. I'll be here for only about 8 minutes, folks. The first passage is to the first people group, those that are not saved. It's a warning because love warns. And then the second passage is very encouraging. And I pray it would be for all of us. The first passage is in Romans chapter 2, where it warns, but in accordance with your hardness and your impenitent heart, you are treasuring up for yourself wrath in that day of wrath and revelation of the righteous judgment of God, who will render to each one according to his deeds. See, the Word of God here warns that when we die, we will be judged by a holy God according to his holy law. We will have to give an account to every thought, action, every deed, every sin that we've ever committed. Even the things that we thought of that were sinful, we will have to give an account. Whether it be lust in the heart, sexual immorality, and that means heterosexual or homosexual, whether it be stealing or lying or cheating or covetousness or dishonoring our mother or father, we've all sinned and we've all fallen short of the glory of God, especially me. And it says that we will have to give an account to every thought and deed that we've ever committed against the holy God. Because God is holy and just and righteous, he cannot allow sin to go unpunished. And he promises that those that are unrighteous, those that have not been justified, those that have not been forgiven, those that have not been born again, he will cast them into the lake of fire, which is the second death. But my friends, here's the second passage I'm going to share with you. Chapter 8 of the same book of Romans, and this is very encouraging, and I pray this will be applicable to everybody here. It says, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose, for whom he foreknew he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Moreover, whom he predestined, he also called, and whom he called, he also justified, and whom he justified, those he, Christ God Almighty, also glorified. In this passage, it says, all things work together for those that love God. Who are those that love God? That's the second people group that I talked about. That's those that are born again and written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Jesus said, if you love me, you would keep my commandments. Do you love God? Do you keep his commandments? Or do you strive to do so? Are you born again of the water and the Holy Spirit? And it says that whom he predestined, those he called. The doctrine of predestination. God, great God Almighty, had already predestined the day I would be saved, even without me knowing that I would be saved. He knew I was going to be saved on November 14th, 1991, born again. Before that, before I even knew that would happen. And then it says, those whom he calls, he justifies. This is what happened to me. I got justified. This is the doctrine of justification. What Christ did on that cross for me, I will speak for myself because I know that I'm saved now, is Christ, the second person of the Trinity, justified me and declared me righteous before the Father, the first person of the Trinity. And then the Holy Spirit regenerated my heart, the third person of the Trinity. He justified me just as if my sins never happened. Christ declared me righteous. Christ bore my sin, and Christ bore the wrath that I deserve on that cross as he atoned for my sins. That's what Christ does. That's what Christ will do for those whom he justifies. And then it says, and those whom he justifies, he will also glorify. The doctrine of glorification. Amen, brother. And listen, the doctrine of glorification, that means when I die, when I go in the grave, when Christ comes back, the second coming of Christ, Jesus Christ, will raise those that died in Christ, and he will give them a new body in heaven. The doctrine of glorification. Folks, glory, pun intended, glory. So my friends, we know the consequences for our sin is death, judgment, and hellfire. But it doesn't have to stop there. Here's the good news. God sent a remedy for our sin problem, folks. Please, I hope you know this. This is the good news. Oh, this is good news. The gospel that God came to us in the form of a man. The second person of the Trinity, Jesus Christ, perfect, sinless, spotless Lamb of God, conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the virgin birth. And then Jesus Christ, who knew no sin, then went to that cross 33 years later, and he bore the sins of his church. He bore the wrath of God on those that would become saved. He bore the sins, and he atoned for the sins of his church. Those that would repent and believe in that, folks. And then Christ was buried in that grave. And on the third day, Jesus, who is the resurrection and the life, resurrected from his grave. So that you too, if you become saved, if you become that second people group, you too will rise from your grave and be glorified with a new body in heaven. Where there is no more pain, no more tears, no more sickness, no more sin. And then Jesus Christ ascended into heaven where he's seated at the right hand of the Father right now, folks, where he will intercede on your behalf if you become saved. Scripture makes it very clear, folks, if you repent and believe in that and put your faith and trust in the finished work of Jesus Christ and trust him alone for salvation, you will be saved and he will be saved from your sins and you will be saved from the holy wrath of God. My friends, what will it be, heaven or hell? Please call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. Cry out and call out for Jesus Christ to save you from your sins, folks. And that concludes my message. If anybody has any questions, or if you want any prayer, I'd be more than happy to answer any of your questions if I know the answers. Or if you want any prayer, I'll pray for you as well. I love you dearly, folks. Thank you.